There aren't enough jobs in marine analysis. I get this comment from some people I know in the message me, and they tell me, "Look, Amr, I searched for jobs in marine analysis and I don't see enough jobs. Maybe that field is not so important." But let me tell you this. The truth is, especially after Agile and different things, and in general, organizations, they don't need malware analysis only jobs. The thing here is that malware analysis is really a big thing. Malwares are really a big threat. But there's not so many malware attacks that worth that deep investigation. What happens is that if you're working only as a malware analyst, you get to have long idle time until you start working on something. And for that, companies don't feel it is worth the investment to only hire a malware analyst. What is needed right now, and this is what I see in the market these days, is that they want someone who is able to cover the incident response or the malware incident response in general. So you're able to respond to malware attacks and able in general to be a good team player. Especially with, as I told you at the beginning with Agile, that the Agile mentality is that there's a team and there's everyone can play a role in every different task. He may be specialized in one thing, but he's able also to do testing and he's able to do this and this and that and able to cover for his team. The same thing happened with malware analysis. I used to work as an incident handler and I worked in a team where we have someone for digital forensics, someone for log analysis, and someone for malware. But here's the thing. When the attack is not a malware attack, I do the log analysis work. I did other works other than just malware analysis. What is needed right now in the market is more of a person who is a good team player, who is able to cover incident response, malware analysis, digital forensics, memory forensics, and able to respond to an attack, who is able to really contain an attack. First, you need to have the same basics. You need to understand how attacks look like, how they go from one step to the other, how malware attacks look like, how spear phishing attacks, how to analyze a document, how to get the malicious domain, how they maintain resistance, how they escalate privileges, how they do all of this, how they do the lateral movement step by step. So understanding the whole attack infrastructure. Then understand how the incident response process look like step by step from the initial phase of detecting the attack through log analysis and then the network forensics, memory forensics, digital forensics, and malware analysis. What we do now in our training is that we do cover all of that. We do cover from the log analysis, we do cover the whole incident response. So the log analysis, memory forensics, malware analysis, and we are adding as well the digital forensics. So here's the thing. If you want to actually be able to find lots of jobs in the field, you need to learn the whole incident response process and search for jobs that are targeting incident response in general. Even approaching managers who are incident handling managers or incident response manager or SOC Tier 3 managers and tell them about how big the impact that the attacks that you are able to protect against, what are exactly your skills, what's the proof of your skills? This is things that you have done, this the malware you have analyzed, or this is memory image that you have analyzed, whatever the task is, whatever the way you can prove your skills. And last, that you ask them if they have an opening in their team, you could be a great asset for them. If you keep it professional, you can approach managers and they will be happy to hire someone who actually can cover malware analysis and as well incident response. So this is my two cents today. Make sure that you understand you have a wide variety of skills. You don't have to be excellent in everything to find an entry job. You just have to know the basics and what is mostly common. Malware mostly common in Windows. Forensics, if you are dealing with malware, mostly common, the most commonly will be Windows for you. If you are the same thing for log analysis, you can learn Splunk or Kibana, and you just use one or two tools, and you're able to deal with them. You understand how log analysis look like. You understand basic of Wireshark, or quite more than basics, and you're able to do some analysis on it, and that's it. We do cover all of that in our training. I'll put the link as well up there in the description. So make sure that you check it out and see you the next video. Bye-bye.